brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sin and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear of all these statutes and say, "This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people, for what great nation is there that has God so close to it as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as this whole law which I am setting before you today?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the letter of St. James. Dearest brothers and sisters, all good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no alteration or shadow caused by change. He will to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Humbly welcome the word that has been planted in you and is able to save your souls. Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deluding yourselves. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their affliction, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. The word of the Lord.
Hear me, all of you, and understand. Nothing that enters one from outside can defile that person, but the things that come out from within are what defile. From within people, from their hearts, come evil thoughts, unchastity, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, licentiousness, envy, blasphemy, arrogance, and folly. All these evils come from within, and they defile. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our readings today talk about God's law, his commandments, his statutes, those things that we are called to follow and live in our daily lives. The first reading comes from the book of Deuteronomy, which simply means the book So Moses, speaking to the people, says, "Now Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe." And so God's commandments, as we call them, are not just mere guidelines. God's commandments, God's statutes, are called to be followed and lived. Yes, they guide us, but they guide us closer to the Lord. And they're meant to be followed as a way of life. And when we follow the commandments and the statutes of God, we find our ultimate and true happiness. We know deep in our hearts and in our minds what our Lord is talking about in today's gospel from Mark. Like Moses, he says to the crowds, "Hear me, all of you, and understand. Nothing that enters from outside can defile that person, but the things that come out from within are what defile." And if we look back and think carefully, it's true. Thoughts creep into our minds, anger, feelings from within the heart. That's what consumes us. That's what defiles us. Things from within. And so the remedy of that is Jesus Christ, the gift that God has given us, the gifts that we receive outwardly, the sacrament of reconciliation. Envy. Any of those things in our hearts, bring it before the Lord. When we approach Jesus in Holy Communion, I've been saying that over several times, the same kind of concept. Lord, help remove these things from my heart. And he has the ability, the power, and the grace, and the strength to do just that. All we have to do is be open. But when we close our hearts, God's love and mercy, that poisonous venom, eats us up inside. And it creeps up and it festers and metastasizes and it grows. But then we need the mercy of God. We need to hear the word of God preached to us. And we need then to make every effort to open our hearts to the prompting and guidance of the Holy Spirit. Now, in talking about this, the Lord is calling out the hypocrisy of the scribes and Pharisees. Because in God's commandments, God's statutes, what we have to recognize is that there is the literal meaning of them, and there's a spiritual meaning to them. Because we have to understand what it means. You know, one of the things that we hear Jesus list at the end of the gospel, he says, murder. So let's look at that commandment, thou shalt not kill. Do we understand what that really means? I mean, we understand that it's not the direct, that killing is the direct killing of someone, of course, with direct and intentional. But do we understand that we perhaps violate that command more often than we realize? For example, gossip, slander, when we talk about others behind their backs, we're killing their integrity. We're violating that commandment. We could look at the others as well. To understand the deeper meaning, that's why we should study the commandments a lot more. To understand what they mean. The literal, the spiritual. Because obviously, the scribes and Pharisees, I truly believe, were trying to follow the commandments. But in doing so, their true hearts were far away from the Lord. And that's why he calls them out. When he responded, well, did Isaiah prophesy about you hypocrites, as is written? Jesus Christ, the Son of Man, called them out. Because he, as God, reads minds. He read their minds. And by calling them out, he wasn't being mean. He was actually being very loving. Because he knew they were hard of heart. So he used the word intentionally, hypocrites. Because he wanted them to open their hearts. Because he loved them. He says, you disregard God's commands and you cling to human tradition. And then he challenges the thinking deeper. So when he summons the crowds, Jesus is teaching. You know, sometimes the Lord does that to us. He opens our hearts and minds to things. And sometimes it feels like that we have the wind knocked out of us by God. That's a nice thing. He really opens our hearts and our minds. And so the Lord is teaching us that the fullness of the commandments, the fullness of the statutes of God. God's own that we are called to follow. And as we hear in the letter of St. James, this is one of my favorite lines. Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deluding yourselves. Meaning, when we hear the word of God, we're called to act upon it. Sometimes we hear the word of God and we fail to act. That's not how we're called to respond. We're called to respond by hearing and doing. To care for the most vulnerable, the orphans and the widows in their affliction, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. And we talk about being unstained by the world. You know, it's very easy to become cynical, especially when we see what's going on in the world around us. And I invite us today to please pray for peace. Pray for our servicemen and women, our allies who lost their lives this week. Pray for peace in our world. Pray for all those who are suffering from different natural disasters even going on in the world. And the storm that's coming up the coast, it's looking like it's heading towards New Orleans. Pray for them. It's very easy, especially when we see everything going around us, to become very cynical. Best thing to do, of course, we're aware of what's going on around us. Sometimes turn off the TV and just be doers of the word. Teach people by our actions of love, our mercy. Be doers of the word. Humbly welcome the word that has been planted in you and is able to save your souls. That word is planted in you, and that word grows through humility and the grace of God. Be doers of the word. Demonstrate God's love, his justice, his love. And we demonstrate his love, and we be doers of the word, following the commandments and statutes that he's given us in their fullness, in their entirety. We will live in the presence of the Lord. We will live in his presence. And not only will we live in his presence, the more we're doers of his word, we open up the opportunity for others to live in his presence as well. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things are made. For us then, and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our Savior was crucified with Pontius Pilate. He fell to death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy and Catholic and apostolic church. I confess the baptism of forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. The gift of faith is shown in our actions. May these intercessions we make for others strengthen the quality of faith in action.
For a spirit of compassion and fidelity throughout the universal church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For strong and effective solutions to alcohol and drug abuse in our society, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For single parents and their children, we pray.
Lord,
thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of his holy church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, O Father most holy, your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, to whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining from you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life
of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. I'll be right back.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you and our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A couple of announcements. This is the last weekend to sign up for religious education. I realize we ran out of forms in the back. While I'm uploading the Mass to YouTube, I'll try to print out a few more forms, put them in the back of church for this weekend, but we'll get them later in the office by Wednesday so we can plan on ordering material. Also, the convent did go on the market this week. It went on the market on Tuesday morning. Our asking price is $296. I've been in contact with a realtor a couple times this week. She's had at least two showings, and we already have one offer. And so we're looking at that thing, everything as it comes in, and then we'll make a decision. But you know, things are moving in that direction, so hopefully within the next few weeks, we will be able to, with the signing off the dice, of course, be able to sell the convent, and the proceeds from the sale of the convent will be put towards our parish deficit. And so that's in the work. Was it, did I say 296? 196. I'm losing my mind. I wish it was 296. I would have seen that on the video and be like, what did I say that for? I'll just claim that I'm going to see my classmates yesterday in Ben Salem and be in the park for 5 hours. Use that as my excuse. So, but thank you everyone and for your prayers and your support. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your gods.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle.
Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of hell.
May God give you the honor and prayer,
and do not want us to stand in the midst,
but the power of God, cast us in place safely with all evil spirits,
who are our Lord, seeking to win us all souls.
Amen. Our
closing
hymn,
Saint
16, seeking first, number 8.
Spirit. Amen. God bless you. I hope you have a wonderful weekend.